Greetings. I need to present this video. It is more political than spiritual. But after watching it, you may see the spiritual implication of the politics. I recently mirrored a video about liberal hatred for America. It caught the attention of a rather vocal liberal. She began the exchange cordially, but included flawed statements which I challenged. You know how that goes when you begin to point out the problems in the thinking of Muslims? Well, liberals exhibit the same lack of any spiritual awareness. I've actually called her a unicorn because she claims she is a Christian liberal. And I've actually called her a doorknob, a comparison for which I readily apologize to doorknobs everywhere. We've sent easily a dozen messages. And I will share some interesting ideas she holds in the coming videos. She claims to be a researcher working important theories about the research I do is on the effect of the right-wing pundit system on followers. Its effect is to foment the same inner hatred. But it was something else she messaged today that is really revealing. It has taken me a while to get them to see it, but academics I work with, as far up as Lakoff at Berkeley, are realizing the language used by the right today is similar to what is used before a genocide. The tactic is to make the enemy seem less human, ungodly, and the only threat to the country. I'm not saying y'all are ready to kill all the hippies, although given the chance, I have no doubt a few of you, especially Christian, would jump on that. I am seeing the narrative the right is forwarding about liberals matches that type of language. I'm sure you'll love that one, but facts are facts. Pause a minute and let that whole statement sink in. In fact, rewind and watch it again and again. This is the web and people can and do say anything. But there is, in fact, a Professor Lakoff, or Lakoff, at UC Berkeley. Framing the issues, UC Berkeley Professor George Lakoff tells how conservatives use language to dominate politics. This is from 2003. You can see there's a George Lakoff, UC Berkeley Professor, there in 2003. You can find more recent articles and things, speeches he's given. Conservatives have spent decades defining their ideas, carefully choosing the language with which to present them, and building an infrastructure to communicate them, says Lakoff. Doesn't sound too conspiratorial. So maybe the unicorn has interacted with Professor Lakoff. But that makes her statement a little scary. Given Lakoff is a professor of linguistics and arguably skilled at carefully choosing the language with which to communicate himself. The language used by the right today is similar to what is used before a genocide. Talk about some scary hate speech from the Berkeley unicorn. If you think about it, there are at least two people and allegedly more who are busy studying to present the case that Christians are genocidal terrorists. I've wondered for years what might cause the U.S. government to persecute Christians, scarcely thinking it possible. But here are Berkeley liberals actively studying to make the case that the right, Republicans, Tea Party folks, and Christians are a terrorist threat of genocidal scale. Take this seriously. The foundation is being laid for liberals to openly persecute Christians as genocidal threats. The tactic is to make the enemy seem less than human. If you are a Christian, perhaps you recognize the feeling liberals create that you are stupid to believe in God. The only threat to the country. The Christians being talked about will be called a threat to the country. I'm not saying y'all are ready to kill all the hippies, although given the chance, I have no doubt a few of you, especially Christian, would jump on that. I'm not saying it, I'm just saying it. This is some pretty scary and disturbing stuff from a seemingly legitimate, in-the-know liberal. The talking points memos and buzzword mantras are probably being prepared. It will include the current favorites, extreme and extremist, in some forms. And I expect terrorist and genocidal will be added to allow the TSA and other Homeland Security orgs to be unleashed. So pay close attention to how the left attempts to frame the description of Christians this year. Still, the most befuddling facet is that Hope, the unicorn, claims to be a Christian. Pray for her that God will open her eyes. And pray that God will give you wisdom in the days ahead. We know what is coming. We are not in darkness and we are not asleep. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.